afternoon. Wherever you are from, thank you for making the trek. Welcome to St. Matthew Catholic Community as we celebrate the Epiphany of the Lord. Tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock, we invite you over to St. Pius X Church for their annual Epiphany concert. This features choirs and ensembles from all around the Cedar Rapids area. Our very own St. Matthew Chancel Choir will be one of the featured groups. Admission is free, and they are also collecting food and monetary donations for Metro Catholic Outreach. This weekend, we are encouraging you to bless your home for the year using the kits near the entrance of the church. The Epiphany House blessing is a specific blessing traditionally done each year on the solemnity of the Epiphany. Using blessed chalk, the leader of the household draws symbols above or near the top of the front door to bless the home and all who enter. This tradition was biblical roots going back to the story of Moses when the Israelites put the blood of the lamb on their doorframes at Passover. The Epiphany blessing includes the numbers for the current year, 20 and 22, as well as the letters C, M, and B, which hold dual meaning. They stand for the names of the Magi who visited Jesus, Caspar, Malachar, and Balthazar, as well as the Latin blessing Christus Mansinum Benedicat, which means may Christ bless this house. When you leave church today, please take one Epiphany home blessing kit and participate in this tradition this year. Please stand.
In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather this day to celebrate these sacred mysteries on this feast of the Epiphany, we place ourselves in the loving presence of the Lord as we ask for his pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to the people of will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God,
almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen. Let us pray. May the splendor of your majesty, O Lord, we pray, shed its light upon our hearts, that we may pass through the shadows of this world and reach the brightness of our eternal home. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity, Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you he appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar. and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of the nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Judgment enter the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people of other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. We saw his star at its rising, and have come to do him homage. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising, and we've come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people.'" When Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance, he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out, and behold, the star they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over a place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. And they prostrated themselves and did him homage, and then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When the wise men arrived at the manger scene and they saw Mary and Joseph and the Christ child, they were filled with great joy because the star led them to the city of Bethlehem, and that's where they saw the Holy Family. For our reflection today, I think that this gospel passage causes us to think about the fact that the three kings, they were searching. They were in search of the Christ child. But King Herod was also in search of him, not to do him homage, but to destroy him. So as we think about this gospel passage today from the Gospel of Matthew, it asks us, what are we looking for? Are we in search of God? Do we undertake the hard journey to find what we are searching for? What are the kinds of things that people search for today? Some people are searching for love. Others search for opportunities to improve their lives. Some say they're looking for a sense of meaning and purpose. Due to COVID, many people are quitting their jobs to find a sense of purpose in life and not just working a job to make money. The social reformers are looking for justice. Some say they're looking for truth. Those on the survival level simply say that they're looking for something to eat. And so whatever it is that we or others are looking for, we want something better in life. We are all searching for some kind of salvation. In essence, we are searching for a sense of happiness and a sense of joy. St. Augustine says, "You have made us for yourselves, O Lord, and our hearts are restless until they rest in thee." Like St. Augustine, we may have searched for happiness in pleasures or ideas, works, travels, fitting in with a popular crowd. And if we are serious in our search for happiness and true contentment in life, it's not found in things. We were led to the manger, the same manger that the three kings were led to. This search leads to Jesus. In knowing Jesus and loving Jesus and serving him in this life and in the life to come. The three kings looked for Jesus and they found him. St. Augustine, after living a life of debauchery, looked for God, and having found him, he wrote these words, "Late have I loved you, O beauty ever ancient, ever new. Late have I loved you. You were within me, but I was outside, and it was there that I searched for you. You were with me, but I was not with you." Today's Feast of the Epiphany, a feast of searching, encourages us to keep looking and trying our very best to find the Christ child in all the experiences of life. Keep growing in the knowledge and love of Jesus, because I believe with all my heart that he is the fulfillment of our quest. There we stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible.
I believe
one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, the light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father.
Through him all things were made.
For us men and for our salvation, he came down
from heaven.
By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sakes, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into the heaven,
and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son, who with the Father and Son is adored and glorified, he has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the sins.
I look forward
to the resurrection of the dead
life of the world to come. Amen. So as we stand before the Lord's presence here this day, we offer to him now these prayers of petition.
For the Pope and all church leaders, may the faith of the church be a guiding star to all people toward Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all influential figures in science, medicine, and research, may they lead us to seek the one who made what they study rather than worshiping knowledge. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are threatened by government leaders, may they find peace, protection, and guidance in Christ alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to all disease and illness, especially the coronavirus and soon, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the St. Matthew family, especially as we continue with the capital campaign, may we always strive to offer our very best to God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All who have died, and especially for all deceased members of St. Matthew over the years, may the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Dear Jesus, we ask you to hear the petitions we're spoken, and those remain with the quietness of our own hearts. You know what we need in our daily living, and we ask all of this through Christ our Lord. My sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, our offerings in honor of the appearing of your only begotten Son and the first fruits of the nations, and to praise you, and that to you praise may be rendered, and eternal salvation be ours, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, he made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. We're indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup, proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence the Father and the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Novena prayer to St. Teresa for the capital campaign. Glory to St. Teresa, whom Almighty God has raised up to inspire the human family. I implore your miraculous intercession.
You are so powerful in obtaining every need of body and spirit from the heart of God. Holy Mother Church proclaims you prodigy of miracles, greatest saint of modern times. Now I fervently beseech you to answer your petitions.
And to carry out your promises of spending heaven doing good on earth, and letting fall from heaven a shower of roses.
Little flower, give me your childlike faith to see the face of God in the people and experiences of my life, and to love God with full confidence. Saint Teresa, my Carmelite sister, I will fulfill your plea to be made known everywhere, and I will continue to lead others to Jesus through you.
Our Father, one Hail Mary and one Glory be in honor of St. Teresa. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. St. Teresa, the Child of Jesus,
pray for us.
Let us pray. Renewed by sacred nourishment, we implore your mercy, O Lord, that the star of your justice may shine always and bright in our minds, and that our true treasure may ever consist in our confession of you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
One peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.